Episcopal Church in downtown Syracuse and offering some remembrances from members of the family. From the Detter family, Susan, Frank's sister, Rick and Danny. Dear Frank, our sorrow when you lost Andrew was immense, not just for Andrew, but because you could not say goodbye and never saw him after he got into the ambulance and was rushed off to the hospital. Andrew was a fantastic addition to our family. He totally took to Dan, and we could all see how much Andrew enjoyed him as a baby, but also as he grew and came to Connecticut for weekends in the city. Andrew made gatherings fun and even more celebratory. We will miss you dearly, Andrew. Love, Rick, Susan, and Dan. The Kimball family, David's brother Frank, Emily, Joe, Lauren, Samantha, Michael, and Julia. We are saddened that Andrew will no longer be a physical presence in our family. We really did not get to spend enough quality time with Andrew over the years. When we were together, he loved to hear about what the children were doing. This gave him so much enjoyment. Especially Lauren was an Irish dancer. We will never forget the caring manner in which Andrew talked about his beloved nieces and nephews. Andrew's death was sudden, and we feel badly about the way he died. But we could not let this day go by without sharing some of our warmest memories of him. The way he patiently let the kids fool with him. The way he quietly enjoyed the chaotic family gatherings, and especially the way he spoke of his fondness for dancing. After his passing, when we saw images of a younger Andrew dancing, we immediately understood the joy he felt performing and sharing his art. Andrew touched so many lives with his kindness, caring, loving, and peaceful nature. We are all blessed to have been part of his life. The Buckley family, Kate, who was Frank's sister, Matt, and Matt Jr. For Andrew. Andrew, you have been a part of my life for so long, I hardly remember the time that you weren't in it. I remember getting the chance to watch you dance, and I remember how much I loved it. I remember how much fun we had going into New York City to see Chicago on Broadway with Mom and Frank. I will always remember the Thanksgiving dinner we made together a few years ago. Thanksgiving dinner by Andrew and Kate. The way you embraced and loved our Maddie, you are forever Uncle Andrew. He always loved spending time with you and Frank, especially when you taught him to play solitaire on the computer. Always there with a hug and a kiss and a smile. Thank you for embracing me and in time, my little family, as your family, as you will always be part of ours. Mary Kimball, Frank's mother. My memories of Andrew. The first time I met Andrew, he had KP duty at my sister's house. He was helping her as she entertained friends and family after her daughter Amy's college graduation. Even in that hot kitchen, on that very hot day, elbow deep in hot, soaking water, he was happy to see everyone. One of my strongest memories is Andrew with a happy expression and warm greeting for all. Andrew was a dancer for many years and was highly thought of. When he reached the time when he could no longer perform, he began choreography and was successful at that. Andrew loved the arts and enjoyed that lifestyle. He accepted a position at Starbucks as a barista. I'm not sure what he anticipated when he took the job, but it turned out to be a good fit. He could interact with the customers and became friends with many. And also for him at that time, it came with benefits. This was not a bad thing. Among the things that also gave Andrew pleasure was spending time at Old Forge in the Adirondack Park. He liked walking the trails, walking through town, and eating at the Pied Piper. He was equally fond of Stone Harbor, New Jersey, walking the beach and sunning. Wherever he was, he had a healthy appetite and enjoy fine dining or diner dance. Diner dining. He was kind, enjoyed good conversation, reading, music, and snoozing. For me, I loved Andrew, and I loved that he and Frank enjoyed such a happy partnership for 32 years. His loss has been a blow to all of us. Please remember us in your prayers as we grieve. Mary Kimball, loving friend and mother-in-law. Mary Maul, Andrew was more than my cousin. He was really like a brother. One of the earliest memories I have of Andrew was when he must have been around 18 months old. He was staying at our house. It was like he was a new puppy. My mom had just finished giving him a bath, and suddenly he escaped giggling and ran outside completely naked. We all had to run after him, and when we finally caught him, he was still laughing. He was provocative way back then. I remember all the family gatherings at my grandparents' house for Christmas, Thanksgiving, and Easter. The kids would always go upstairs and flop on the beds between the courses of an Italian grandmother's feast. I remember all the times I was with the babysitter. We always had fun when they weren't making me old before my time. We also had many memorable vacations in Cape Cod, at the county fair, and backyard parties. We stacked wood in the garage in Maine. I once slept on a bare mattress on the floor in his apartment in New York City. Okay, I actually want to forget that one. I would go see his performances when he lived in Portland. I remember that cute apartment that had one thermostat temperature, hot. We would eat lobster and blueberry pie. How about the time Andrew ordered the $27 sandwich at Orloff's in New York City, and me secretly wondering how the heck I was going to pay for it? I remember all the performances of the grandest opera and ballet balls imaginable, done in the kitchen after dinner. The list could go on for years. No matter what memory I have of Andrew, all of them are special. Andrew's kind heart and gentle soul will always be with us. Stephen Giambattista, Andrew's brother. I have three memories that make us smile. Celestial soup. We always enjoyed our vacations to Cape Cod, at least 5 times. Our visit always included dinner at Bonnie Doon Restaurant. Sadly, no longer around. On one occasion, Andrew ordered the New England clam chowder. After one taste, he declared, "This clam chowder is heavenly." He always had a colorful way of describing food. Andrew's criticism and Grandma's response. Gathered around the breakfast table at Grandma and Grandpa D's in West Seneca, Grandma asked what we would like to have. Andrew asked for eggs in the basket. Grandma happily obliged. After serving Andrew his dish, Grandma asked how it was. To our surprise, he said, "Good, but..." And Grandma calmly said, "Better luck next time." To translate, Grandma does not make mistakes with her cooking. We now refer to the dish as "better luck next time eggs in the basket." Bert Cruz. We took a cruise to the Bahamas to celebrate Mom's birthday. The whole family was there. The first excursion was to an island owned by the cruise company. Andrew, Matthew, Elisa, and I opted to go to the beach. After a while, Matthew and Elisa and I left to get something to eat. Andrew stayed. The next time we saw him was at dinner. He was burnt to a crisp, red like a boiled lobster. He said it didn't hurt, but it hurt us looking at him. He loved burning in the sun. I miss you, Stephen. The DiGiambattista family, Matthew, Andrew's brother, Elisa, and Elizabeth. Hello, Frank. Hopefully, as time passes, we will smile more when we think of Andrew rather than cry. Hugs and kisses. Matthew. There are so many fond memories of Andrew, it is hard to pinpoint only one. Some of the most memorable moments were when he performed from piano recitals to acting and singing in musicals, and especially ballet. say he is my brother. The memories will never fade. My love for you, big brother, will be cherished. Elisa, I have loving memories of sweet and caring Andrew, like the last time together, just the two of us hanging out by my in-laws' covered patio, watching the rain and talking about family worries. To silly times, we would all play cards, or the time we all decided to team up to a game of pool players at the family reunion in Gatlinburg, Tennessee. But Will, remembering Andrew is easy because at any time within family gatherings, he never failed to approach and take a few moments for personal little chat with me. I miss that kind of sweetness. John D. Giambattista, Andrew's brother. When I was a young teen, during a couple of summers, I would spend a week or two with Andrew when he lived in Portland. Seeing how Andrew was over 11 years older than me, it was always so much fun to go and spend time away from home and hang out with my older brother. I remember taking ferry rides to explore Peaks Island in Casco Bay, finding the best two lobster dinner deals in town, and exploring Old Port. There were mundane things too, especially in the earlier days, that were just as cool to me. I remember helping him move apartments, carrying a couch down the street, and going grocery store shopping where Andrew shared his hard-learned cost-saving tips, like how generic brand mac and cheese is the exact same thing as Kraft. My fondest memories of these trips, however, was watching a Planet of the Apes movie marathon on his small TV, complete with rabbit ears. We watched all five movies. I'm pretty sure it was spread across a couple of nights, usually with bowls of ice cream. Both of us were surprised by how much we couldn't wait for the next movie to start. I hadn't watched any of those movies since then. I think it's because I know that it just wouldn't be as special as watching it on that tiny little TV in that tiny apartment with my big brother, Andrew. Belinda, Andrew's sister-in-law. Andrew was the life of the party. He was warm and inviting. He was also loud and loved attention. He loved family time, having a delicious multi-course dinner with fine wine and, of course, a great coffee. Andrew is memorable. Anytime one of my family members talks about John's and my wedding day, their first memory is Andrew meeting everyone is one of the most fun dances they've experienced. They always ask me about John's brother. Andrew loved the finer things in life, always living each day with the fullest. Andrew loved to tell stories about his younger brother and parents. He was proud to be a D. Giambattista. I remember the last time we saw him. We're so thankful that he went on a trip that led Andrew to stay with our kids for nearly a week while we were away. We got to spend a little time with him in the afternoon when we came home. Our kids and Andrew had the loveliest visit. They said so many kind words about Andrew. He was fun, funny, relaxed, helpful, and on and on. He never raised his voice. May we all try to be a little more of those things and live by his example. Sam, Andrew's nephew. While looking back on a few years ago when we visited Uncle Andrew in Connecticut, I remember going out to eat lunch at the Mexican restaurant. We had already hung out for some time before leaving, taking amongst ourselves and snacking on whatever goodies he had in his kitchen. You could feel the sense of warmth while we were all talking. Joy was brought to all our faces. Whilst eating lunch, I remember seeing a whole jalapeno on his plate. I remember I made a comment along the lines of, "Oh my God, imagine how spicy that is." Then he proceeded to eat the whole jalapeno in one bite of. At the time, I thought it was the most impressive thing in the world. It shocked me. While this memory may not seem very big, it stood out to me for some reason. I think that this memory stood out not solely because he ate a jalapeno, but because the entire visit was an overall amazing time. Claudia, Andrew's favorite niece. I remember one time when my parents were away in Colombia, and we had a million people watching us, and Andrew was one of them. He would play games with me and my brother, and we had a lot of fun. Unfortunately, that was the last time I ever saw him. I don't remember much about him, but I do know that he was very loving, playful, and open to new ideas and games, and he supported me in everything. Even with his medical conditions, he would always buy a lot of Girl Scout cookies to help me reach my cookie goal. He was such an inspiration, and it is sad to let him go, but I know that he is in a better place now. Claudia, his favorite niece. Sam and Jenny DiGian Battista, loving parents. The toddler who moved to the music. The teenager who made it happen by committing to ballet lessons. The man who became more creative. He guided his life to make his dream come true. We watched with pride the growth and development of his talents. He was our starving artist, a man of many talents, a generous, outgoing spirit, working hard to bring joy to others. Somewhere in heaven, he is cooking and making pizzas, all the while describing in detail a wonderful dinner he had at a favorite restaurant in Stone Harbor. Family time became precious, a visit always too short. A love for all of us always evident in his hugs. Our lives moved in so many ways, but some things never changed. His smile, the bear hugs, the simple hi, mama, hi, dad, always greeted us. Memories of all the Christmas Eve dinners, everyone participated to make them the most important part of our holiday celebration. Memories of Andrew that we hold in our hearts, the long talks, lingering at the family table, the love and devotion for Frank and his family, all the children in the family. His special time with Sam and Claudia was a wonderful gift to him. He welcomed Lisa and Belinda as sisters. The times he would annoy his brothers, Stephen, Matthew, and Jonathan, and then pretend to be an innocent bystander. You were a strong and generous son and brother. Someday we will ride the clouds together and dance among the stars. Till then, we wrap you in our love. Mom and Dad. Frank Kimball, loving partner. I met Andrew in late January of 1988. We were at a club in Portland, Maine, Zoots, that was known for its eclectic or alternative mix of music and patrons. It was the first time I had ever heard Enya's Orinoco Flow played in a dance club. Out on the dance floor was Andrew and Lisa, whom I later became good friends with. They appeared to be having a good time, so I decided to join them. From then, it was like a shooting star that blazed in the sky. We quickly learned a lot about each other. We both hailed from upstate New York, Buffalo, and Syracuse. We came from large maternal families and were the eldest in our immediate families. Our worlds could not have been more different, artists versus business person. We quickly immersed ourselves in each other's worlds, learning and navigating through new territory. That spring, we moved in together at Portland Pier. It was a fantastic townhouse on a working fishing pier where our combined friends would mingle for many parties. Shortly after, we were faced with one of our first big decisions. I was being offered a job promotion that would take us back to upstate New York, someplace I do not think either of us had ever considered. So move we did. Andrew found a wonderful position at the Orcutt Botsford School and a part-time job at Canal Town. During our 4 years in Rochester, we made many lasting friendships that continue today. Again, another move was in our horizon, an opportunity to move to Connecticut to further our careers, after settling in Norwalk, Andrew had the opportunity to work, dance, teach, and choreograph at Ballet Etudes. Andrew was also fortunate to have a position with Starbucks, which proved to be a good match for him. Being in Connecticut seemed to be a good fit for both of us. We were able to travel more, explore New York City regularly, and take advantage of spending time with friends. In some ways, our life had become easier and more relaxed. Perhaps that is something that happens with age, or when you know someone, like a book or fine wine. Several years ago, Andrew was diagnosed with myotonic muscular dystrophy. Andrew did his absolute best to put on a brave face. We were fortunate to find wonderful and caring doctors who took great interest in Andrew's well-being. If only there had been no pandemic, if only Andrew knew of the hole in my heart that will never be mended, if only he knew that my world, no, our world, has been torn apart, but the pieces do not easily fit back together. I think that this best describes my feelings and my life without Andrew. To paraphrase W.H. Auden, he was my north, my south, my east and west, my working week, and my Sunday rest. My noon, my midnight, my talk, my song. I thought that love would last forever. I was wrong. The stars are not wanted now. Put out everyone. Pack up the moon and dismantle the sun. Pour away the ocean and sweep up the wood. For nothing now